Hi everyone, we're representing the Department of Medical Education.
We appreciate your nomination. Thank you for your help and support.
We'd like to share with you a little bit about what we do each and every day. I hope you guys enjoy.
In a land far, far away, down in a valley called Derby, Connecticut, 40 years ago, an idea was nurtured to go forth and combine education with patient-centered care. The journey of 1,000 miles began with one step. Griffin Medical Education Department was born. Since then, many have walked these hallowed halls.
'Twas night shift, 3 a.m. Not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse, except blue elves in scrubs.
Attention, rapid response, room 666.
The patient, he came in with the AFib. He was rapid response and.
You think the patient that clearly came in science rhythm was an atrial fibrillation? Did you check the vital? Did you talk to the patient? Is this your patient? Are you taking care of the patient?
This ain't easy. Get the family.
You ever love somebody so much you can barely see when you with them that they lay sick and dying, but you just don't want to let them be at peace because you miss them already, but they ain't gone. Beep, beep. Ventilator alarms. I swore I'd never harm them, never do nothing to hurt them. Hippocratic oath, prim them, not no surrender. Now I'm forced just to torture them. They push full code, no one knows what his wishes were. His sister heard him say once, I don't want to be a vegetable. But no one agrees in the family. The caregiver, Kate, wants some comfort care, but Aunt Claire lives so far away. Batter guilt eats her like a cancer, so she answers, wait,
I'm full code.
My case is on pulmonary tuberculosis, and I'm a second year resident.
Where's the van? Can you page him, please? He's late.
Okay. Then, 36-year-old woman from Pakistan presents to me.
Pakistan. So tell me, what do you guys know about Pakistan? Give me the three things most commonly known
right,
in Pakistan. The most important. Fahim, please tell me.
Dr. Souza.
Baby, you should know this by now. You're taking your boards in 2 weeks. Come on.
Sorry.
Can the med students answer or are you guys?
No. Residents. Come on, Ajanta, next.
I need a doctor. Call me a doctor. I need a doctor to bring me back to life.
Mother, may I?
No, you may not. Take 3 giant steps backwards.
Mother, may I?
Yes, you may.
I have my elective tomorrow. Do you know where I'm going?
Tomorrow? Are you kidding me? Oh, I should have told you to stay out there. Yes, you may.
I need a lab coat.
Monica, do we have any lab coats that will fit him?
I am not sure. We have to check.
Abe, where's your lab coat now?
I lost it.
Oh, it's probably in your car.
I don't have a car.
I'm telling you, Abe.
Try this one on.
I just... That'll be fine.
This is too small.
No, who cares? Who cares? Just go. It's clean. It's white. Go ahead.
So here we are today, talking about medical education. I've been here for 5 years, you've been here for 3 years. A long, long time. So let's talk about, say, how was our experience through the years? We've been an observer, we've been an intern, we've been a resident. So what do you have to say?
Sita, I must say that we've actually come a long, long way at Griffin. Starting off as an intern when there were paper routes, do you remember that?
I remember that. You know, we used to remember we used to take the charts and try to read the handwritings. Oh my God, messy. But remember how we transitioned into the Meditech? HMPs, progress notes, consult notes, amazing.
The transition definitely was tough, it was hard. But look where we are right now, and I actually love it.
Mm-hmm. So Fatima, let's talk about our faculty. I think I've learned from each one of them. Although they've had a high turnover rate, I would like to say thank you to all of them.
And despite the difficulties that they've had with the high turnover, I think their focus has always been on education, which we really appreciate.
Absolutely. How about the clinic, Fatima? We've had a long experience, starting with the Hill Health, and then an interim clinic, and obviously now the new clinic. What do you have to say?
Well, as residents, we've had difficulties, there was a transition, but I think we've been really adaptable, and the faculty has been very supportive in that regard.
I would say a big thanks to all the faculty who have been through the years supporting us in the clinic and taught us every single day.
Most importantly, MedEd cannot function without the support of the ancillary staff.
Yes, and the list is long. Nurses, case managers, respiratory therapists, unit clerks, MSTs, it goes on.
We appreciate your support.
No matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry.